start, had to make up a lot of ground, didn't panic. Gable with a tremendous start and got away from the rest of the field, eventually qualifying in second place there. I can tell you there's a disqualification for Joost Smit and their advantage for Maciej Przyzik from Poland. He'll make it through. So now heat number three. That's the lineup. Satoru Karao from Japan. Didn't get through to the finals yesterday, but was a semi-finalist and finished in eighth place. Then it's Fabio Carter for Italy. Nikolay Fedorenko for Kazakhstan. And then Kieran Hansen. So Satoru Tarao for Japan on that outer track. Kieran Hansen for Australia in track number two. The Italian Fabio Carter in three. And on the inside, Nikolay Fedorenko for Kazakhstan. So Corral for Japan out in front. It is in fact Johansson who's in second place for Sweden. Then the Kieran Hansen for Australia in third place. Nikolay Fedorenko for Kazakhstan in fourth at the moment. Tarao looking over his shoulder. Johansson in second place. These two with two laps to go, pulling away. Kieran Hansen with an awful lot of work to do at the bell. He's not going to make it. Hansen will not qualify. Satoru Tarao for Japan, a big cheer for him. Tremendous race. He goes through. Martin Johansson for Sweden in second place. .43.63 the time there for Tarao. And a blistering start from him. You see Johansson trying to get his nose ahead. Tarao just whipping round the outside. There Tarao really bouncing round these corners. Johansson tremendously determined. So there the winner of the third heat, Satoru Tarao from Japan. 1-1 Steel Bradbury, Australia. Number 1 Hill, Eric Feder, Canada. Number 116 Alexei Iglin, Russia. Number 128 Miki Gucci, Great. So their confirmation of race number three. Corral and Johansson making their way through to the next round. So the lineup for heat number four. Mirko Willeman for Italy, Stephen Bradbury for Australia, then Canada's Eric Berda, Alexei Ivlev for Russia, and Nicky Gooch for Great Britain. Gooch in 19th place at the moment. Didn't get through to the semi-finals yesterday. Willeman in third place. Silver medal for him in the World Championships last year. In fact, the world record holder, there he is. He's the man to keep your eyes on the outside. Eric Berda for Canada on the inside here. And it's Bradbury for Australia in the middle. And Bradbury looked to be a little bit quick off the line. So important, as I was saying earlier, that to get into that first corner in front. Post number one, post up. A lot of nerves out there, as you can imagine. So for the second time of asking, there this time. Stada didn't waste any time. It's Bedard for Canada out in front. Stephen Bradbury for Australia in second place. Nicky Gooch for Great Britain in third. And there's a fall there. So Nicky Gooch in, well, just into second place now, pushing Bradbury down into third. Two laps to go. And Bradbury goes. So out in front, it's Eric Bedard for Canada. Nicky Gooch for Great Britain finishing in second place, but will there be a disqualification there? Well, there you can see Ivaliv knocking out Mirko Vuleman. And down goes Bradbury for Australia. So what will be the situation here? Eric Bedard for Canada, no doubt about it that he's made his way through. Nicky Gooch finished in second place, but we'll have to wait and see what the judges have to say about that one. Well, the Japanese isn't too good, so I can't tell you exactly what the officials are saying, but I reckon that Nicky Gooch and Alexei Ivaliv will be disqualified. Stephen Bradbury getting an advantage there. There he is, just taking the boots off Bradbury for Australia. Indeed he does. So Eric Bedard for Canada goes through. Stephen Bradbury with an advantage there. Mirko Vuleman in third place. Disqualifications for Alexei Ivaliv and Nicky Gooch for Great Britain.